Hi guys, I'm Neha Gupta. You all know me that I'm your mentor for current affairs for phase 1 examinations like RBI, SEBI and NABARD. So I hope that all of you are doing very well, and today in order to spice up your morning with knowledge, I have come with most important and interesting current affairs. So we will be starting the video right now, but before that I would like you to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell notification so that whenever we come live you get the instant notifications through this bell icon. Do subscribe and hit the bell icon as well as join this Telegram group. Now here is the table of content in which I have taken 5 news and I will be describing the news in a very brief manner. So first news is the president of International Solar Alliance. Quite important from the title itself that the president the country which has been recently elected as the president of International Solar Alliance is the first topic that we are going to discuss. The second is IMF's projections on India's nominal GDP growth rate. Now you would be thinking that in the yesterday's video only we had discussed India's GDP projections. So what is this? Wait till the second question, because this is something new. I'm not going to tell you the GDP projections again. There is something new to this question and we will be discussing that in the second slide or the second question. Now we have the third question, we have a new report on India's startup ecosystem. Quite an important and interesting news. You will be enjoying this news, I would say. So do watch the third question. Do listen to me in the third question very carefully. Then we have Rashtriya Kamdhenu Ayog's new chip, which is named as Godsava Kavach. Quite important. The title itself is saying this thing. Then we have Foreign Contribution Regulation Amendment Bill 2020. Now guys, you would be thinking that monsoon session of parliament is over and this has been passed quite a long period of time, like in the monsoon session itself. Then why I have taken this again in this video? The reason is that the bank has been chosen as the official account holder of NGOs under this bill. So that is why this is in news and we will be discussing that in the last question of the day. So do watch me, do listen to me carefully till the end of this video. So here comes our first question, which is about which country has been elected as the co-president of International Solar Alliance along with India. So from the question itself, it is clear that one of the president is India and the co-president that we are talking about here is France. So India and France have been recently elected for a 3-year term at the International Solar Alliance. So that was all that we need to keep in mind from the examination point of view from this news item. Now guys, if we are talking about International Solar Alliance, then we should look into the background of this organization because it is very important. Firstly, it is an international organization, and secondly, the president has been elected of this organization and that is why it is in news. So therefore, we will be discussing the background of this organization. In this slide, I have put International Solar Alliance and all the facts related to International Solar Alliance in this smart art. So first fact about this alliance is it was launched in 2015 at the Paris Agreement conference. And as the name itself is suggesting that it is the Solar Alliance, so what could be the purpose? To promote solar energy, solar renewable energy. Then its headquarters is in India and it was co-launched by India and France. So India and France are the co-founders of International Solar Alliance. Do remember this thing because it can be asked in the examination. Now the second point of importance is that International Solar Alliance is the first treaty-based international organization which is headquartered in India. This is quite an important fact that often students miss out. So you don't have to do that mistake. You have to remember this thing that ISA is the international organization which is the first treaty-based international organization based in India. Now what is the third fact that we have to look in? The third fact is member countries and signatory countries. So members are 70 and signatories are 88. Now you would be thinking that what is the difference between members and signatories? There is a basic difference. The difference is that member countries ratify the treaty. If there is any kind of treaty and if a country is a member country of that treaty, that means the treaty provisions are being implemented in that country also. The country is adhering to the provisions mentioned in the treaty. And if a country is a signatory of a treaty, then it means it has just signed the treaty and it has not yet ratified the treaty and it is not following the provisions of the treaty yet. So this is the basic difference between members and signatories. I hope that it is clear. They have implemented and they have not implemented the treaty. So this is the basic difference. And here this question ends. And if you have any kind of doubt, you can ask me in the comment section below. And this is our second question. So which South Asian country is expected to surpass India in 2020 in terms of nominal GDP according to IMF projections? So in the South Asian region, India is the fastest growing nation. China is not counted in South Asia. Do remember this thing. So we are talking about South Asian region in which India is the most developing country or is the most is the fastest developing country. And right now IMF is saying that another South Asian country is going to surpass India. So this is tragic and this is shocking for Indians that we are going to be surpassed by another country which is at a lower level in terms of economy than us. So which country is this? It is Bangladesh. So Bangladesh is going to surpass India and it will have a nominal GDP growth rate. Sorry, not growth rate. It will have a nominal GDP in absolute terms at $1,890. And what would be the India's nominal GDP? So it would be $180. So 1880. So this is the basic difference. This is the basic amount. These are the absolute amounts that you have to remember from this news item. Now, apart from the 2020 projection, the IMF has also made projections for 2021 and 2025. So let's have a look at those projections also. So here, India is represented by Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Bangladesh is represented by Bangladesh PM, who is Sheikh Hasina. Do remember her name. Because we are talking about Bangladesh here, Bangladesh has been given spotlight. So you have to remember the Prime Minister as well as capital and currency of Bangladesh, which is quite easy. So you will be telling me the capital and currency of Bangladesh in the comment section below. So here are the projections. In 2020, India's nominal GDP would be this. In 2021, it would be this, which is higher than the nominal GDP of Bangladesh, per capita nominal GDP of Bangladesh. Then in 2025, again, India will have a lower per capita nominal GDP than Bangladesh. So these are the three nominal GDP projections that have been given by International Monetary Fund, and you have to mug up the facts because this is the section where no trick works. You have to remember certain facts, you have to memorize certain facts in current affairs. So here this news ends. Now another question I have to from you guys. You have to tell me that where is the headquarters of International Monetary Fund? This is quite an important information that you should know being a current affairs student. Now here comes our third question, which is how many unicorn startups does India expect to have by 2025 according to COVID-19 and the anti-fragility of Indian startups ecosystem report? So this is a new report which has been released by TIE Delhi. Now TIE Delhi is an NPO, non-profit organization, and Zinnov. So Zinnov is an international consultancy company. So these two private organizations have together launched this report. Do remember this fact as well. Now this report mentions that by the year 2025, India is going to have almost 60,000 to 62,000 startups, And out of these 60 to 62,000 startups, 100 startups, which is the answer, 100 startups would be unicorn startups. So these are the two facts that we have discussed till now. Apart from these, the other fact that this report mentions is that in the year 2020, there are 8 startups that are expected to become unicorn. Out of these, 4 have already become unicorn startups, and the remaining 4, if the remaining 4 startups become unicorn, then the total number of startups that India is going to have at the end of 2020 would be 33. Quite an important number, because it is telling us that at present means at the end of 2020, India is going to have 33 unicorn startups. Do remember this thing. And also that if the remaining 4 countries companies become unicorn, only then we will have 33 unicorn startups in India. Now, what is a unicorn startup? You would be thinking that, right? So unicorn startups are those startups who have a worth of over 1 billion. So this is the net worth that a startup needs, that a startup requires to be called as a unicorn startup. Do remember this limit as well, because it is a very basic question that can be put in the examination. So that's all that we need to cover from this report, because we have discussed all the facts relevant for the examination. Now we will be moving on to our next question. So the next question is, which of the following company has manufactured the cow dung chip named as Godsava Kavach? So what is this chip? Godsava Kavach is a cow dung chip, a chip that is made out of cow dung. So why is this important? The reason is that Rashtriya Kamdhenu Ayog, that is the National Commission for Cattle, so it has recently launched this Godsava Kavach chip. That is why it is very important. Now, what is the purpose of this chip? It is to reduce the radiations that are emitted by mobiles and electronic products. So that is the basic purpose of this chip, and it has been launched by Rashtriya Kamdhenu Ayog. Now, which company has manufactured it? So the answer is option B, Shriji Gaushala. This is a Rajkot based company. Do remember this thing, and it has manufactured this Godsava Kavach. Now, apart from this, the Rashtriya Kamdhenu Ayog has also launched a campaign. So what is this campaign? The campaign is named as Kamdhenu Deepavali campaign. So let me write this for you guys. Now, what is the purpose of this campaign? Since the word is Deepavali mentioned here, it is very obvious and very clear that it is to promote the products that are made up from cow dung or from the panchgavya. Panchgavya is the mixture of 5 products that are derived from cow. So what are those 5 products? Milk, urine, cow dung, and ghee and curd. So these are the 5 products which constitute panchgavya. So promote those products that are made up from the panchgavya. That is the main purpose of this campaign. And what kind of products does this campaign aim to promote? Firstly, earthen lamps, pots that we use usually to decorate our houses on Diwali. So that is the main purpose of this campaign. Now, apart from this campaign also aims to boycott Chinese products. So if you are promoting Indian products, then obviously we will be abandoning Chinese products. So that is the main purpose of this Kamdhenu Deepavali campaign. I hope that it is clear to you. And now it's time for us to discuss the Rashtriya Kamdhenu Ayog, because as I told you that it is very important for us to remember the Rashtriya Kamdhenu Ayog, what it is and what is the formation date of that Ayog. So this is the Rashtriya Kamdhenu Ayog. Rashtriya is national in English. Kamdhenu is cattle. and most prominently that we are looking at is most prominent animal is cow. So kangaroo is usually used for cow and Ayog is commission. So what is the purpose of this national cattle commission? It is to promote and conserve the cows of India. Now it is launched under Ministry of Fishing, Animal Husbandry and Dairy. So this is the other fact that you need to keep in mind. Apart from this, you have to remember that this Ayog has been recently launched. So recently in 2019. Do remember the year as well in which this commission was set up. Now what is the other fact that we need to pay attention to? It is very clear on the screen itself. So it is the chairman of RKA. So he is Vallabhbhai Kataria. So he is the chairman of this commission. I hope all the facts that I have told you are clear to you. And in case you have any kind of query, you can ask me in the comment section below. And here this question is complete. We have discussed all that we need to discuss about that question. Now comes our last question, which is, which of the following branch has been designated as the official bank for holding the accounts of NGOs and associations receiving the foreign funding under Foreign Contribution Regulation Amendment Bill 2020? So first of all, let's discuss this amendment bill, then we will be discussing the answer of this question. So what is this amendment bill? Firstly, if it is an amendment bill, then it is amending an act. So what act it is? It is Foreign Contribution Regulation Act 2010. Do remember this thing, that it was the 2010 Act. Now, this amendment bill aims to provide transparency in foreign funding. So what is the purpose of this bill or what is the objective? Firstly, to bring transparency in foreign funding. And how is it going to do that? Firstly, that it has mandated Aadhaar as an identity proof for NGOs and any kind of non-profit, non-government organization which is receiving foreign funding. So these organizations do need to have an Aadhaar card, and that should be verified by the banks. And secondly, the foreign organizations that are providing funding to NGOs need to have the OCI card. What is this OCI card? OCI is Overseas Citizens of India card. So this is the identity card that foreign companies need to have. And this is the identity card that Indian domestic NGOs or firms need to have in order to receive foreign funding. Now, which banks? Because we are talking about the bank here, we are talking about the foreign funding. So that is why the bank has been designated as the official branch. A bank branch has been designated. So which bank branch it is? It is State Bank of India's New Delhi branch. Do remember this New Delhi as well, because a question can be put up from here also, that in which branch of SBI or which branch of SBI is the official bank holder, account holder of NGOs under FCRA Amendment Act. So here we have discussed all the things that are required from the exam point of view, and I hope that you have really liked the session. And if you have really, then do subscribe to our channel and hit the bell notification. Thank you.